Is this supposed to make a sound? Should I try another one? Do none of these make sounds? Let's see if this works instead. Happy New Year! Wow, you can smell smoke. Ah, this reminds me of how we ringed in 2020. It was rain, sleeting, there was, my hands were slippery and I couldn't do the popper. Complete fail, which then led into 2020. Hi, I'm Brenda, and welcome back to Daily Dose Of, and welcome to a whole new year. Maybe I can insert a sound effect here. And also, happy Friday. Let's take a deep breath in and let this last week go. A few quick announcements before we go into today's video, which is a drugstore glam look. First things first, if you've noticed, or maybe you have not, because you wouldn't, but anyways, I've moved around a lot of my videos. You can't actually see a lot of them anymore because this channel has been around for 5 years, and I'm not the same person I was 5 years ago, and I'm not even the same person I was 2 years ago. So eventually I'm gonna be making a second channel to archive a lot of that footage, so you'll still be able to see it. It's more for just me, my friends, family, because I definitely don't regret vlogging. It has been a great digital diary to keep track of all my memories, but I just don't want it to be always part of the DDO channel. Announcement number two is that this year I will be uploading every single Friday. That is a goal I have, and hopefully I'll achieve it. We'll see. So far this Friday, you see a video and it timed out really well. It just feels like a nice, I know I used to try to do Sundays, I try to do Wednesdays, but Friday just feels like a good end of the week, tune in, see a nice little makeup look, which brings me to announcement number three. Every single Friday, I will be uploading something makeup and skincare related. Occasionally, you'll still see a few vlogs on here and maybe something that's cooking related. I might do some random videos on Wednesdays, but for Fridays, just expect something beauty and skincare related. I'm just gonna try to curate this a little bit. Now, nothing is set in stone except for the Fridays, okay? Expect to see me every single Friday. Everything else content-wise could be a little bit fluid because we're all artists here. Everyone's a creator. Everyone, just do what your heart desires. And today it desired to save money because I spent a lot of money on Black Friday and a lot of money on Christmas. So I went to the clearance section of Walgreens and bought a bunch of products to slap onto my face. Now without further ado, let's hop into this look. We are starting with a clean and moisturized face. I have my headband on with little kitten ears to keep my hair out of my face. And instead of my beauty blender today, we are going to go in with the Ekle Tools sponge. This is a little bit stiffer than the beauty blender. What I do like is that it's got this slanted flat edge on the top, and then it's still got the round bottom. So you could be able to blend a little bit better. Personally, I still prefer the beauty blender, but this does the trick and it's a fraction of the price. So for my foundation, I'm going in with the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Makeup. This has titanium dioxide sunscreen in it with an SPF of 17, which isn't a lot, but better than nothing. And I'm going in with the shade N4 Buff Beige. The thing about drugstore foundations is it's really hard to get a good gauge of what your shade is. So I was just kind of like holding this up to my face in the store. So we'll see. Also, this doesn't have like a pump. This is a little bit of a messy setup. Honestly, this is blending quite well. It's offering a nice medium coverage, but isn't quite giving that cakey feeling. Not bad so far. And the shade match is actually not bad either. This is the palest I've literally ever been because I didn't go to the beach a single time in 2020. So sad. So next, I would usually go in with my concealer, which is the Maybelline Age Rewind, but for the life of me, I cannot find where it went. If I were Maybelline, where would I sit? I don't know. Things have been going missing all week. I had a journal that I've been keeping all year. Don't know where it went. Haven't left the home. Where could it have gone? You know, like that guy in Halloween Town, I think his name is Gore, you know, where his lost things go to his home. Maybe that's where all my stuff is. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a little bit more of this foundation on the brush and just going in to some places that I have need a little extra coverage on. I got this nice little handy sponge holder from Morphe over Black Friday because the Beauty Blender comes with like a little bottle and you could put this, when it's big, you put it on its stand and as it dries, it falls in. But the Eco Tools one never really came with one, so now it can stay sanitary. Moving on to the contour, I am just going to take the darkest shade in this palette, suck in those cheekbones like a little fish. Did you know that in Chinese culture for New Year's, you're supposed to eat fish? Because it's what do you call it? One of those words that it sounds the same, but it has two different meanings. So the way you say fish and the way you say like plentiful is the same pronunciation, but different characters. So you're supposed to eat fish because then you have a plentiful year. It's a creamy contour, but I think it might be a little light for me. And this is the darkest shade in the quad. Oh, you can kind of see it a little bit. And just with my ring finger, I'm gonna go in and, oh shit, this is too dark. Oh, honestly, okay. It blends in quite well. I wanna try the lightest shade right here, the top. Do you feel like that did anything? Is my nose like popping out at the screen at you? So we're gonna go with the ColourPop Pressed Powder Face. This is technically a highlighter, but ColourPop is technically still a drugstore-ish brand. So we're gonna take this. It's just a little bit more luminescent and dust it all over the face. So for blush, I am going in with Sleek Makeup Blush by 3. This is the palette Sugar. And I am going to be using Demaria. Now that the face is set, I brought y'all a little closer because we're going to my favorite part, which is the eyes. So to start, I am going in with the NYX Tame and Frame Tinted Brow Pomade. According to the internet, this is supposed to be a nice dupe for the Anastasia pomade. I'm going in with a Kiko Cosmetics Angled Brush. Okay, it's quite creamy. Oh, wow. The pigmentation is actually quite nice. Taking a little spoolie and let's soften this guy up a little bit. Look at the difference between the brows. This is fantastic. Always remember, eyebrows are sisters and not twins. Sometimes they're adopted sisters, but they get along really well. The first thing I'm gonna do on my eyes is I'm going in with Revlon's Illuminance Cream Shadow, and this is in the shade 711 Black Magic. I'm just gonna go in with this white shade right here and try to set a base. Morphe 166 brush. It's a little streakier than I would like it to be. Kind of reminds me of really shitty face paint. I did get this on clearance for like $3. Okay, it seems to definitely work better if you do a pat. Next up, we are going in with the Revlon Photo Ready Eye Art, and this is in the shade 080. Desert Dazzle. I'm going in with the green side. Looks kind of like a lip gloss applicator. I'm gonna draw in where my crease is. Taking a Morphe 152 brush, blending this guy out. Really doesn't blend. Now, if there is anything we've learned, it is first step is never the last step. Okay, what I'm gonna do instead is, you can't get any precision from this little applicator. I'm gonna take the dip out. I'm taking this Morphe 410 brush, taking a little bit of the product. The pat is the way to go. I'm going back in with the Morphe 166 brush. Going back in with the white. All right, once that is cleaned up a little bit, I am going in with the e.l.f. Sunset Prism eyeshadow palette. And we're just gonna go with the lightest Hella Fallout. I'm pretty sure this palette was free with a purchase. We're just gonna set that cream white. Once that is all set, I am going back in with this Revlon Photo Eye Art, and this time I'm going in with the glitter side because it would not be a New Year's glam look without glitter. It dries pretty quick, so if you are going to move it, make sure to move fast. I'll be right back to match my other eyeball. Wow, it is way easier to use the brush from the very beginning. Now that both eyes are caught up, I am going in with some eyeliner. This is just an oldie but a goodie. It is the Maybelline Gel Eyeliner in Blackest Black. Zio and I used to use this in high school. I'm going in with the Morphe 158. It's just the other end of the spoolie brush. I've never actually tried any gel eyeliner that wasn't this one, so I recommend it, but I also don't have anything to compare it to. But it's honestly quite creamy. So for my favorite part, we're going in with some false eyelashes. I'm going in with the Duo Eye Glue along with Ardell's Demi, Double Demi eyelashes. As you can see, I already got that little bit trimmed off. Maybe you're new here. I trim a little bit of my false eyelashes on the outer corners just to match my eye shape. Sometimes they just come a little too large, which is probably better than coming a little too small. So I don't know what you're gonna do in that instance. All right, now that the eyelashes are done, we are going in with the last and final product. This is a lipstick by Lip Bar. This low-key would have been a really good lipstick to do a lip liner with. Completely forgot. So this brings us to the end of this drugstore glam makeup look. I'm actually pleasantly surprised how this turned out. As you guys followed along, there were definitely some points of skepticism during the middle where I thought some things wouldn't blend. But this just goes to show that you really don't need a lot of money to look really glam. I got half these things from the clearance rack at Walgreens. Anyways, thank you guys so much for following along. I hope you guys had a great New Year's and hope you have a good whole week ahead of you, and I will see you guys next Friday. Bye-bye.